Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough, a switch of characters as I like to do for each video. Oh no. This golf. This would be an awesome concept for a minigame in this. Unfortunately, it's another one of those things where it just doesn't feel like it works all that well. I'm of course gonna be doing all 9 holes. Oh my. Okay, here's how it works. You see, this is your hole. Your typical hole of sorts, and the objective of disc golf is to throw your disc at that banana capsule thingy to break it open, and you'll finish the hole. Now, the thing about this is, you see this arrow? You can only change its direction when it's at about this angle. Now, if you want to change its, like, loft, you actually have to hope that you keep it at its right spot, and then lower the Wii remote down to wherever you want it to point to. See, at this point, you cannot move it left or right, and that is incredibly awkward to do because of the fact that you are working in a 3D space, and it also gets kind of like stuck at some points. But anyway, the wind is at the bottom left corner there. It's indicated by that flag, and depending on the ferocity that flag is waving depends on how much wind there is, which is also not usually a very good indicator of the wind. Anyway, to lock your position, press and hold the A or B button, and then swing the Wii remote forward to throw it while releasing the A or B button. Woo! And I didn't have it quite high enough, but I suppose that's acceptable. Alright, gonna aim for the banana capsule. Will it be successful? No! And you also have to hit the glass. You can't hit that thing. You actually have to aim for the glass. And, come on. Please, thank you. Yeah, birdie! I think I could get an eagle on that hole if I actually, you know, got there by, well, I would have to have a better first throw to have a better shot at my second throw, but anyway. Yes, I am ready! Can I make it over that water? I am unsure, actually. Oh, and by the way, pressing 1 to check the map doesn't help you at all, really. I mean, I guess it gives you an idea of where you would want to position yourself, but you can't aim yourself while you're in the map mode, so that kind of defeats the purpose a little bit. Since you can pretty much see what's going on, you know, right here. Oh, and also, depending on how hard you throw the... Whoa! Poopers! The disc depends on how far it goes as well. So, you also have to be wary of your arm speed as you're throwing it. Or wrist speed, of course. Yeah. Oh, man. Where the heck am I? I'm, like, hovering above the water. Obviously, I'm not, but... I must have came really close to the edge there. Wait, let's for the fun of it see. Wow, that camera really gives you a false impression of where you're sitting. It looks like I'm like 9 yards away from the water, and over here it's, well, okay, it's probably like only 3 feet, but still. But I mean, it just looks like that I'm above the water when I'm up to actually throw the disc, and please let me, thank you. And I threw it right over the glass capsule somehow, even though I could have swore that was pointed directly at it. Alright, gonna play this with the wind, I guess. Yeah! Double bogey. And believe me, things get a lot trickier. I guess this isn't quite as bad as I remember it, I suppose, if you can say that. So, but let me turn. And that's another thing, you have to actually use the arrow to turn the camera. You can't, like, use the D-pad or something like that. Please, I don't want to go there. I want to be about there we go. That's what I mean about that arrow being a little bit... Ooh, that was a close one. Being a little bit tough to control. So it's a little more clunky than it needs to be. In fact, I would actually prefer controlling this arrow with the D-pad, if anything. Did I make it? Oh, I bounced off the capsule. Could have got Albatross there, but alas, it is not to be. Albatross is also a double eagle, by the way. Oh, come on! Maybe this is why I hated the game when I played it before. Because I would end up throwing the disc over the thing, even though it doesn't look like I'm going to. Am I behind this tree? It sure looks like it. And I don't believe that your wrist angle as you throw the disc matters in the slightest. Although, yeah, I was behind the tree, wasn't I? Alright, guess I gotta play out here. I just couldn't tell by the... Just gotta carefully navigate myself around the tree. And... Oh, please hit it this time, PkGam. I beg of you. Yes! Yes, PkGam is a second person in here. If you didn't know that, there's like two commentators. Maybe three sometimes. looks like I could go over the mountain if I wanted to. Or go around it. Interesting, I have to say. I think it would actually be safer to go that way, because... Come on, turn the camera. There we go. Because it would be a little more... Like, I would be in more control over where I want to shoot. I think right there. I don't know, the wind may push it towards the water. I'm going to do a really good throw here. Rather than a more controlled short throw. Okay. Ugh. Or I can hit the mountain somehow. Dang it! I could have swore I would have been able to get over there because the wind was in my face. So what that would do is give the disc more loft. Or at least that's what a frisbee would do normally. Believe me, I've thrown a frisbee before. This is a little bit off. And... Get up there! Oh, maybe I'll be able to hit it from this distance. I pray that I can hit it from this distance. Needless to say, your lower shots go further than your higher shots. Well, not shots, your throws. I'm thinking too much golf here, not throwing golf frisbee thing. Because, you know, you're going for distance and not loft to get over things, and you probably get the idea. It's basic physics of sorts. Come on, I would like to, I think, there. Don't go over and into the water. Did it look like I was throwing over this glass thing? It didn't look like it to me, I swear. Okay, let's aim towards the line, I guess. That apparently does it. I suppose with practice I could get that feel down of the angle a little bit better. But something about it doesn't feel very intuitive, if you ask me. Oh, this one, I remember this one. It's one of those things of, do you go towards the right and get yourself into trees, or to the left as well, or do you risk attempting to throw over the water? I think I can use that rock as sort of like a backboard of sorts. Yeah! Not the front ones, poopers! I meant like the ones way over these rocks and over the water. I was just gonna try and use the wind to my advantage. But alas, that was not to be. I probably didn't have it high enough. See if I can get over those trees. Ugh! Or I can just shoot right through the leaves. That works perfectly as well. You'd think that the disc would get caught in the leaves, but that is apparently not the case. Okay. I'm so scared to shoot over the edge. And wow, I really overshot that. Yes, I know the wind is with me. It's just a matter of had the angle a little too steep, I suppose. That was too low. Please tell me I'm not too close. Okay. And next hole. Oh, wow, this is taking a while. I was expecting the party games to only be like 5 parts or so. I was gonna do like 10 per video. But wow, some of these take quite a while to do. I will just... Oh, that's gonna get caught in the wind too much at that height. Yeah! Look, get up there. Yeah! That was pro. No, I failed. That was not pro. That actually wasn't too bad, though. It was just a little bit too far. Let's try there. All right. Now, if I can hit it from here, I can get myself a par. That was actually pretty close there. And I did indeed go for it. Hey, wait, did the wind reset when I went out of bounds? I think it did. I didn't notice that before. It's kind of weird. Wow, I was really off. I don't recall Frisbees ever acting this haphazardly when you throw them at straight angles. Well, I guess this isn't all that straight, but I mean, you know, when they're thrown flat and they're not thrown with a tilt. Okay, aim for the line. Right there, I think. Oh my god, it just went backwards. I guess I didn't throw it hard enough, or the wind was just that strong. I guess this game is pretty entertaining in the fact that I am either very bad at it or the game is not all that good. Like, it's one of those things that it's hilariously bad, like Rebecca Black's Friday. I hope that'll be fine. Ugh. Oh boy, that's really curving. Oh, the rock saved it! Thank you, rock! I owe you one! I never thought I would say that to a rock before, but I did now. See how much the flag is waving now? That's indicating that there's a lot of wind, as opposed to when I introduced you to that thing. You know, at the bottom left corner there. Wow, that did not get taken by the wind at all. Aim for the line, apparently. Or at least this is what it feels like when I do aim for the line, like it's about that angle. Perhaps that only works when I'm a little closer. This is probably painful to watch. Just get it already! No! It looked like it just stopped on that ground randomly rather than... Not randomly, it's just like stuck. Like it didn't bounce or anything like that, like it should randomly, or I don't know. Yeah! Only a double bogey this time. And I use only in the most lightest term and sense possible. Oh god, no! Why is it so thin? Well, the wind is with me on this one, so I might be able to cheese some of it by getting as far ahead as I possibly can. Alright, Mimi, we can do this. Well, that wasn't too bad, actually. I can use the trees to my advantage. And hopefully get between these. I'm definitely not going to get over them without overthrowing the capsule of sorts over there. Yeah. Good. Oh, almost an albatross. Well, it was on a bone, so I guess not almost. Just not high enough. Come on, eagle. Please let me angle this perfectly.
Yes!
And I was so worried about that hole, and it went so well. What is the last one? Oh my, that's a lot of water. Slightly intimidated, but must beat hole with grace, just like the last one. This is the par 4, that's preposterous! Aw, I'm behind a rock, I'm never gonna get there in 4 strokes, or 4 throws. Alright. It's just you and me, Capsule. No, I'm not gonna try and get over the water from here. I'm going to go and try to get the camera over. Stop getting stuck. There we go. down like so, and gently throw it. That should be good. And oh, I have to get over two pounds of water. At least I think I can get over two. I don't know. The wind doesn't look like it's in my favor. Maybe I should just aim for that middle thin portion. Please work. Oh, that's next to impossible to land on. Let's try aiming off this way. Maybe towards that rock. Rocks are my friend. They're my bestest buds forever. I have parties with rocks. Oh! And buckets of turnips and lint. That is a reference. Please let me get over. Yeah. Okay. I have a shot. And I completely missed that. Holy crap, look at that thing fly. Well, I'm right there, so that's an achievement if you ask me. 59. I don't know what is my best score, but I know that's not good. Wow, didn't even make the leaderboard. This is a pretty long video as it is. Alright, I'll play Fish Catcher. This one isn't that long. I just don't want to like have just one minigame per video. It seems kind of odd. Okay, I recommend you hold the Wii Remote like a dart. And all you have to do is spear the fish using the velocity of your Wii Remote to go move forward. It's just like when you go closer and further to the TV, except this one actually works. And you obviously have to get the fish that you're instructed to get, as you see by that little bubble that appears on the screen, and then you just pull it towards you to collect it. Yeah, and this is very, very violent towards fish, and poor little fish getting stabbed, but they don't seem to have much pain of sorts. I mean, they still seem to flop around quite a bit onto the, I missed the blue one. They seem to still be alive as they're being pulled in. Either that's gruesome, or it's just that, I wasn't really paying attention there. Either it's gruesome, or the fact that they are, like the nerves are just twitching or something, like a dead chicken or something like that. Dang it, I grabbed the red one. 2 times in a row, actually. But yeah, this one does work pretty well. It's just I'm not very good at it. Oh no, I didn't mean to grab the blue one, no! Good thing I grabbed the right one there. I guess it's best to stay far away before you try and stab a fish. And why did I grab? I mean, what did I grab? Ah, whatever. Get one. Aww. That was clearly not the best I could have played it. But that's pretty much Fish Catcher in a nutshell. It works well, but it's kind of boring, actually. It's another pattern of sorts that these party games have. It's either they don't work all that well, or they are exceedingly boring. Oh, I can do free throw, I think. This is another one that works very well, but is so linear that it's not really all that fun to play. You just angle yourself with the Wii Remote by pointing it straight up, and well, actually it's slightly angled, like 45 degree angle, and then you hold the A button then and push the Wii Remote forward to throw the ball where you want it to go. This one you can get down with practice, it takes a little while to get it. Gentle little swoops, there we go. Just little throws, baby throws, to get these front ones. The flashing ones obviously give you more points. Come on. This is not that hard. I'm actually decent at this. Well, I thought I was decent at this. Yeah! Oh, I'm overthrowing the back ones. Who knew you could overthrow the back ones? Actually, I never had trouble overthrowing the back ones before when I played this. kind of odd that I am having this much issue right now. And if you get all of them, you'll get a perfect rank and I believe more points, if I'm not mistaken. I did pretty bad. Maybe I should retry that just to see if I can get all of them into the basket. I should say get a ball in each of the baskets. And then what'll happen is that the baskets will reset and then you can throw into them all over again. Or you can simply aim for your favorite one, of course. Yeah. Yeah, I'll play it one more time because I just wasn't doing very well at that one at all, even though I am normally okay with that one. At least from what I remember. Go! I just might have a strong hand today or something. There we go. That's a lot better. See, you can get the hang of it. That was 3 in a row. Oh, almost 4 in a row. And I'm again overthrowing the back ones. There we go. Still gentle flicks. We'll get that ball far. I wonder if the balls can collide in midair. Never really noticed that, if they do that or not. Perfect! See that my score went up when I got the perfect there. Normally baskets are 10 points apiece. When you get a perfect, you get 50 points for it. I'm not gonna aim for that flashy one. I wanna get another perfect if I can within the time frame, if at all possible. I don't think that's gonna happen. Come on, these front ones are not that hard. You just do a gentle flick. Ah, whatever. You get the idea. I got second that time. That's not bad, I guess. Alright, I think I'll do one more game. Yeah. Alright, I'll... Yes, this is still Jay here. I wish that they would, like, have a profiling system where it would know your name if you select your name when you start the game. Frog Ball. I don't remember this one. Aim for the goal by hopping. Oh, I remember this one now. It's next to impossible because of the controls. So this is gonna be fun. At least fun for the viewer. Alright. You see, you angle yourself with that by tilting the Wii remote and hope to God that you're going to go into the right direction. Oh wait, maybe... No, wait, this isn't the one that I was thinking of that's ultra hard to control, because this is working decently well, actually. Must be something else that I'm thinking of. Alright, can I go in the water? I probably can't go in the water, a la Frogger style. You'd think a frog could go into the water, but I bet you I can go into the water. It's just a matter of... Yeah, I could go into it. Of course I can go into it. You just can't jump as high. Woo! And you can't jump as far as well, apparently. Oh, turn. There we go. Yeah, the controls of this work just fine. It's just that I'm tilting as, like, before I am doing my jump. Oh, wait, there's a slope. Frog's worst nightmare. Get up there, froggy! Yes! No, not that froggy. That froggy is atrocious. You know exactly which froggy I'm talking about, too. Oh man, there's a quicksand pyramid up there, or a moving sand pyramid. I hope I won't be able to get up there. Come on, frog, we can do this! We can get up there together! And why am I turning that way? I was not pointing that way. Turn. No. I just want to keep myself up there. Get up, please. I beg of you. Yeah! That worked. Yeah, that game's not that bad. And it's not too linear, so it keeps things interesting. So, yeah, I approve of this one. Could have got a better time, though, but just wasn't quite used to it. Isn't this more throwing things in basket? Into basket, excuse me? Well, no, you just bounce fruit into the basket. I'll play this and then I'll end off the part. As I said, I'd rather have a couple minigames per part rather than just a few. Ready? Yes, I am! The objective is to tilt the Wii remote to turn your character's direction. And this one also works very... Okay, maybe it doesn't. I was just gonna say it also works very well. Okay, maybe not. I swear I'm holding the Wii remote forward, and it was working good at first. No, I want... Come on. How... Yeah, there we go. Why did that bounce that way? Did you see that? okay, maybe this... No, wait, this does work okay, as long as you keep the Wii remote at a flat plane. But if you angle it at any time... What? Why did that bounce backwards again? Okay, maybe it doesn't work all that well. The high score is 50? Do you get points for getting... Like, do you get multiple points for getting multiple fruit in a row or something like that? I don't really care enough to try that one again. Well, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I will see you in the next part when we do Hammer Throw, and I'm sure many others.